For more on the life of Nancy Reagan and her influence on her husband's presidency, I'm joined by presidential historian Richard Norton Smith. He's joining us today from Grand Rapids, Michigan. So, you know, I grew up in an era where just say no was how I would probably have my first contact with Nancy Reagan, right? But she was also far more influential behind the scenes. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, I think that's true, Hari. I think in many ways, the history of the Reagan presidency is still being written, in part because the full extent of her influence is far from known. I think she took some pains to conceal it. Give you an example. Ronald Reagan was really as guileless, friendly, trusting an individual as his public image suggests. And those are wonderful qualities in a human being. But in a president, they inevitably impose a burden, a compensatory burden, if you will, maybe on a chief of staff or in some cases on a spouse. And that was part of the unwritten job of the First Lady. And some do it better than others. Mrs. Reagan did it superbly. I mean, it is absolutely true. Her overriding objective in life was to protect the man she loved. And she had excellent instincts. She could spot a phony a mile away. She could spot a self-server probably 2 miles away. And Washington, as we all know, is replete with both.
And her advocacy for stem cell research, which broke with President Bush.
Yeah, she was not afraid to challenge perhaps the political orthodoxy. And that is an excellent example. Of course, in her case, it was an intensely personal cause. After all, she was living with Alzheimer's disease, as are millions of other American households. And it's not surprising, just on the personal level, that that she would take such an interest and such a view.
Last time a lot of people might have seen her would have been at the passing of President Reagan. But what did she do in the last few years of her life? I know she was involved with the Reagan Library.
She, the library, I think, was a great source of pride and activity. She was very active from before the library was built. She and the president were both very active in site selection and the building design. And I remember sitting in meetings where exhibits were being considered. And I remember thinking, this woman has a very good eye. She had a remarkable visual sense. She could look at a storyboard, which for a lot of people is a foreign kind of language, and get it immediately, what the point of an exhibit was. And anyway, she was very active in the library. She used to come up regularly, do book signings. And I think she stayed pretty active really almost up until the end. I think she had a lot of friends. Mm-hmm. She wasn't a recluse. And of course, she was Mrs. Ronald Reagan. And I think to the day she died, that was what in many ways defined her.
Presidential historian Richard Norton Smith joining us from Grand Rapids, Michigan. Thanks so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.